करना है। சார் தான் சென்டரா தெரியணும்ப்பா, சார் சவுந்தரராஜன் சார் தெரியறாங்க அவர்.
गुड आफ्टरनून।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम। गुड आफ्टरनून।
गुड आफ्टरनून
मैम। थैंक यू मैम।
या सो शुड आई स्टार्ट मैम? या
यस मैम। गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
इंदिरा थैंक यू सो मच मैम।
यस मैम, कैन वी स्टार्ट?
हां यस मैम,
डेफिनेटली। यस यस,
वी आर वेटिंग फॉर मैम ओनली।
यस मैम, यू कैन स्टार्ट।
ओके। A hearty welcome to everybody for the second session, Subaltern Literature, the Global Resistance. Now I call Dean ENS, Dr. N.S. Subhashree Ma'am, to address the gathering.
So good afternoon all. On behalf of Dr. MGR Educational Research Institute, first year B.Tech and Department of English, I extend a warm welcome to all the participants here. For this EFTP session, second session, I was not able to join in the first session because I had another webinar organized. So I thought I can join in the second session. Thank you for inviting me here. And I would like to congratulate the department for this initiative. I know we are all totally stressed and we are compelled to do so many issues around us, even though we are not meeting each other personally, physically. We are connected together through internet, thanks to the internet age here, and I think we are all daily having different learning experience as far as the net is concerned. Am I right? Yes, everybody daily.
Yes, ma'am.
So many new things, and we explore a lot of things. So thanks to COVID-19 for that. I think even though there are so many other issues going on, one positive point I found here is. Even the non-technical people are able to do and explore the internet and are able to deliver things to the student community, the research community, and the teaching community. Overall, the academics is boomed, and it has not come down even a percent due to this COVID. So I thank everybody for organizing this, the organizers, and it's really a great, what I can say, it's effort in this crisis. To organize such an FDP. I see lot of participants here, around 150. So I think it's a great reach, madam. I congratulate everybody, and I also thank the organizers for giving such a program and popularizing our university nationwide and worldwide. So thank you for giving an opportunity, and all the best for the EFDP. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Now I call Bhuvaneshwari ma'am to introduce the
Dr. Mary ma'am.
Mary ma'am is introducing ma'am. Okay, Mary.
Mary ma'am, she is giving a few sentence, a few words regarding this session on literature.
Yes ma'am. We welcome our beloved Dean ma'am, Dr. Mary Thomas ma'am, to give the welcome address. Ma'am.
Yes. Can you hear me?
Yes ma'am, we can.
Yeah, a very good afternoon to all students, teachers, faculty, colleagues, and lovers of English language and literature. It's really an exciting business meeting like this virtually to listen and gain perspective from different eminent people in the field of teaching literature and language. And it's my pleasure to be here today with all of you. And today the topic is Subaltern Literature, Global Resistance. And I feel it's very apt today because even though the word subaltern was coined in India, it has a global perspective. And as all literature is a mode of expression, and and a mode of expression to give voice to the oppression and the marginalized people. It's a voice of the voiceless, the subaltern. And the concept of subaltern is a culture-centered critical study. It reflects various themes such as oppression, marginalization,
subjugation. Ma'am, excuse me, ma'am. Ask the others to mute their mic.
Yes, ma'am. I'm doing that. I'm just searching overall, having the mic in on, and I'm just.
Ma'am, now. Yes, thank you, Subhasri. As I was saying, literature is a way of expression, and literature is known to give expression to voices that have not been heard. And the concept of the subaltern, even though it was something that found its foundation was in India, it became a global phenomenon with great theorists like Gayatri Spivak and Victoria Lawson, and even Simone de Beauvoir. All the French theorists also brought it to the fore with the theory of the other. What I wanted to share with all of you is before the dais passes on to our eminent speaker for today, Dr. Deva Sigamani, sir. I wanted to say that the subaltern literature, it reflects various themes and in every age and every caste and creed, there is a lot of oppression. In every field, there is oppression. And when people are displaced and they are oppressed, then they want to raise their voices to express themselves. And that is found in the field of feminism, in gender discrimination. There are all different kinds of discrimination, like gender, color, and various kinds of oppressions. And the subaltern concept is a culture-centered critical study. So in theory, the post-colonial theory studies the power and the continued dominance of Western ways of intellectual inquiry, the methods of generating knowledge. In the book Orientalism by Edward Said, it conceptually addresses the subaltern native. So the voice of the subaltern is something that is a voice of the oppressed. And we see that can the subaltern speak? And that is one of the questions that always comes to our mind when we think of subaltern literature. So I'm so happy that Dr. Deva Sigamani sir is going to talk about subaltern theory as well as its global resistance, because everywhere in everywhere in the world today we see oppression, and from time immemorial we've seen oppression amongst the blacks, the color discrimination in America, and the Native American when their lands were forcefully taken away from the Native Americans, and when the Bushmen of Australia were denied their rights. All over the world, we see this kind of oppression, and even in India, and even in times when women were victimized, and even today in society when we find that women are victimized. All this. And here in India, we have all kinds of oppressions. We have caste, creed, and gender discriminations. And other parts of the world, we have ethnic displacements and marginalization. So a set of displaced, oppressed voices formulating their own space of opposition so that they can be heard. So that is subaltern. And the socio-cultural treatment of this in literature, brings about mainstream development in the discourse of subaltern literature. And as such, the subaltern are people who have been silenced. We find all over the world they've been silenced in administrations and in they use politics as a means of silencing them. And hence subaltern social groups create social, political, and cultural movements that contest and dissemble the exclusive claims to powers, and so establish the use and application of local knowledge to create new spaces of opposition and alternative
non-imperialist future. So now rethinking subaltern resistance is something that is very much in the fore in literature studies today, and I'm so happy that our professor Dr. Deva Sigamani sir is going to talk about it to us. And we have to rethink this resistance as a critical social science concept. If you look at it today, during the times of COVID-19, you know, there are so many people displaced. For example, the migrant laborers today, they have been displaced. So theirs is a voice of subjugation. Theirs is a voice of oppression. But if they have to give feelings to that oppression, it has to be done through the mode of expression that is literature. So this is something that is very much in the fore today. And everywhere in the world, there is displacement and marginalization and oppression. And that is what I'm so happy that Dr. Chandrasena M. Rajeshwaran and the English department, we have invited Dr. Sigamani sir to talk about this. Deva Sigamani sir to talk about this this topic, and I'm so happy about it. And I hope you have enjoyable time, because subaltern literature is we have to speak, and who can speak and who will listen? That is a question behind subaltern literature and the global resistance. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Delsley sir, please stop presenting in the screen.
Now I invite Bhuvaneshwari ma'am to introduce our resource person for today's second session.
Thank you, Indra ma'am.
Yes.
Good afternoon all. I am immensely pleased to introduce dynamic resource person of this EFDP, Dr. T. Deva Sigamani, Associate Professor, Department of English, Annamalai University, Tamil Nadu. He has 18 years of teaching experience in the education field. He is a resourceful guide for PhD and MPhil students, not only from his university, but also from other universities like Christ University, Dravidian University, etc. So far, he has produced 22 doctorates and 53 MPhil scholars. There are 7 PhDs and 2 MPhil students under his guidance now. Apart from this, he is also guiding 60 MA students for their project. He has published more than 65 research publications from 2003 in various areas of language and literature. His field of interest is not restricted to one author or one region. His research articles critically analyze humanitarianism in Arthur Miller's Death of a Salesman and All My Sons, Shakespeare's Black, the role of Shakespeare in Nilo's Mama Day, Mass Media and Globalization, Swami Vivekananda, Monk for the Upliftment of Downtrodden, writing short stories and novels, part of classroom activity. These are few pearls from his ocean. He has presented nearly 35 papers in national and international level, like Mark Twain as humorist with the illustration from Huckleberry Finn and facing interviews, etc. Apart from this, he did 3 research funded projects sponsored by CCSLL, UGC, and ICSSR. He is the author, co-author, and editor for many textbooks, monographs, which include Voice of the Marginalized, Indian Writing in English, A Subaltern Perspective. He extended his services as organizing secretary for many seminars, workshops, and coordinator for conducting exams. He acted as a chairperson for many national and international seminars and conferences. He had organized 1-month training program on techniques of teaching in 2014. No wonder, for his knowledge and dynamism, he has received the following awards: Dr. Ambedkar Fellowship Award from Bharatiya Dalit Sahitya Academy, Rashtriya Ratan Award from International Educational Global Society, Outstanding Faculty Award from Win Foundation, Alvi Momani Award from Kattamannar Tamil Sangam. Sir, we wish you to receive more awards like this, and your services to the education field will continue for a long time. Thank you, sir. Now I wholeheartedly welcome you, sir, to enrich us with your knowledge. Thank you.
Thank you, Bhuvaneshwari ma'am. Before we get into the session, Participants, kindly stop presenting anything on the screen. And at the end of the session, unmute your mic. Before that, please do not unmute your microphones or switch on your cameras. Please don't do that. And sir, you can start your session, sir. Ma'am?
Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Sir is coming. She's on screen. Sir?
Sir, present yourself, sir. Hello, sir. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, can I call you? What
is it, ma'am? Sir, you are not. Yeah, I'll just call.
Sir, Dr. Devinagam, sir. Can you hear us, sir?
I think sir is having some technical problem, ma'am. He's trying, ma'am. Chandrasena, ma'am. Sir has some technical problem, ma'am. He's trying, ma'am. He's trying.
Okay, okay.
Hello, sir.
Most respected Chancellor of Dr. MGR University, Dr. A.C. Shanmugam sir, distinguished person head Department of English, Dr. MGR University, faculty members Department of English, Dr. MGR University, all the organizing members and my dear participants. Good afternoon to all.
Good afternoon, sir.
Today, I am going to share with you a new and innovative topic in literature. Everyone familiar with the
sir, one
English
minute,
literature?
Sir. Participants, if you are presenting, then I'll... Sir, one minute, sir. Sir, one minute. Just hold on for 1 minute, sir. Participants, if you are presenting, we have... Sir, okay. Just 1 minute, sir. Participants, if you are presenting, we will remove you because we don't want any interruptions. Please do not present anything on the screen.
Okay,
sir. You can continue, sir. Sir, now you can continue, sir.
Today we are going to discuss a new and innovative topic of literature. Most of them familiar with British literature, American literature, Indian literature, new literature, English language teaching, but we are not familiar with the subaltern literature and literature of marginality. Generally, literature represents the culture and tradition of a language or people. It is clear that literature is constantly changing and evolving. Literature is a contested term as new medium for communication, providing different types of contemporary literature. English literature is a body of literature written in the English language. The writers do not have to be from England, but can be from all over the world. It represents writers not only from different parts of the world and time periods, but it covers every major style of writing as well. It deals with the universal themes and values that help us grow in our everyday lives. It teaches us about different time period and faraway places. At present, the contemporary writers explore the social, political, and cultural issues of the present day, including migration, diaspora, cultural adaptation, caste, class, and race relations. In addition to strengthening our skill as a reader, this section will offer you the opportunity to understand the new literary field, I mean, subaltern literature. Subaltern literature covers about the masses, Dalits, tribals, blacks, the deprived, oppressed, marginalized, neglected, and indigenous section of the society. The term subaltern is first used by Italian sister, I mean, sir, Antonio Gramsci. He was an Italian Marxist philosopher and communist politician. Put on political theory, sociology, and linguistic game. He emphasized his writing on subaltern people, the importance of the word subaltern in as far as class, gender, caste, marginalization, and culture of the society. The word subaltern, drawn from the Latin roots, sub means and alternus means all of it. Is used to describe someone of your rank. It is first used in the military or a class. A class is a class system or in a caste system. It can also mean somebody who has been marginalized or oppressed. In short, a subaltern is someone with a low ranking in a social, political, other hierarchy. It also means someone who has been marginalized or oppressed. Gramsci coined the term subaltern to identify the social groups. Gramsci coined the term subaltern to identify the social groups. Social groups are excluded and displaced from the socio-economic institution of the society in order to deny their political voices. Gayatri Chakravarti Spivak is an Indian scholar and literary theorist and feminist critic. Her book, Can Subaltern Speak?
Sir, excuse me, sir. Request for PPT, sir. Please, sir.
The analysis of colonialism through an eloquent and uncompromising argument that affirms the contemporary relevance of Marxism by using decoding method to explore the international division of labor and capitalism's welding of the world. She used the terms for the colonists, the oppressed people, working class people, gender, and the women whose voice has been muted. The other critic, Ranjit Guha, is a historian of the Indian subcontinent who has been vastly influenced in the subaltern studies group, was the editor of several groups, yearly anthologies. His book, Subaltern Studies Reader, explores the course of the subaltern history.
Mama is presenting, ma'am. Just hold.
And popular to an engagement with more complex process of change and subordination, a variety of changing structures and
people not visible, ma'am. People not
visible. Just wait for two minutes. Wait, sir. We are waiting.
He pointed out that the peasants were denied recognition as a subject of the history in his own rights, even for your subject. Unable to put the peasants' condition and their in correct perspectives, as they could not go beyond limitation were characteristics of his historiographical school. Subaltern people are voiceless because they are completely excluded the speeches of hegemonic discourse. They are unaware of the extent and true cause of their oppression, lack fully realized to disseminate their discontent to a wider audience. They live in isolated area, use localized speech, not easily understood by outsiders, and have little contact with the hegemonic forces, yet is still intimately affected by their every action.
The PowerPoint is
in the 1970s, subaltern started to signify the colonized people of the Indian subcontinent and depicted a new perspective of the history of an imperial colony.
We cannot see the PowerPoint.
In the 1980s, the scope of inquiry of subalterns was applied as an intervention in South Asian historiography. These studies make
அவர் பேசுறாருங்க ஆனா ஒண்ணுமே கேட்க மாட்டேங்குது
குட் கற்பக வடிவு மேம்
ஆ இஸ் மேம்
see the PowerPoint please
மேம் actually மேம் I am informing மேம் there have some problem here மேம்
another 2 minutes we will get the PowerPoint will be
another 2 minutes just wait another 2 minutes ma'am PPT will be available okay ma'am
and kindly mute your audio ma'am so that
Sir,
சூப்பரா
और ग्रामर बेसिक प्लीज आस्क सर टू कंटिन्यू प्लीज आस्क सर टू कंटिन्यू
हेलो
அர்ச்சக வடிவு மேம் ப்ளீஸ் ஆஸ்க் சர் டு கண்டினியூ
அமைதியா இருக்க சொல்லுங்க மேம் அவங்க பாட்டு கிட்ட பேசிட்டே இருக்காங்க மேம்
ஓகே
Just cancel the drama. Yeah. Yes, scroll it. Scroll it.
Ma'am, which page do you want, ma'am?
I think sir is continuing in the second slide, third slide, probably. Yeah. Can you zoom it a little more? Third slide.
Third slide, okay.
I think sir is speaking on the third slide. So just...
Now we are able to see it.
Yes, ma'am, third slide.
Yeah. Yes. Better view, Rama, better view.
So you can start presenting first.
Deva Sigamani, sir, you can start presenting, sir.
Sigamani, sir. Start presenting, sir. Sir, start presenting, sir.
Okay, Madipa.
Present, sir. You can proceed.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay.
Subaltern discourse highlights the conceivable political achievements of the collective in the radical struggles to recover the history of the self, rebellious and resistance before and after India, Canada, Australia, New Zealand, South Africa, and South African independence from the British. Post-colonial period is an important one for the subaltern, because both the nation and the people have just been relieved from the terrible clutches of colonial rule. These periods are determined to reproduce the colonial experience of the subaltern in literary works. Subaltern writings are narrative of trauma, pain, resistance, protest, and social change. These writings have a profound social obligation, where majority of the writers try to create a classless society. Subaltern literatures like Dalit, tribal, African or black, and Aboriginal document the sufferings and atrocities committed upon a large section of the population. These subaltern, under the subaltern literature, Dalit literature, tribal literature, black literature, Aboriginal literature discuss the same issues. I mean,
Rama, I think you have to change the slide.
What's the slide meaning of the subaltern? Subaltern is economically, socially, politically neglected groups. So the Dalit literature also the same sense. So Dalit literature is a writing of the pain and agony. Its beginning can be traced to be the undocumented oral folklore and tales of the past decades. It is a genre was established in the 1960s and 1970s when a spurt of Dalit writing was published in Marathi. Dalit literature is a recent offshoot of Indian literature, and it represents an emerging trend in Indian scene. It is primarily a social and human document, which deals with the people who have been socially, economically, and politically exploited in India for hundreds of years. The Aryan invaded India and implemented new law of Varna to protect the nation, particularly subaltern. Ancient, medieval, early modern India excommunicate untouchables from all injured not consistent of indigenousness untouchables.
Accidentally you have disconnected the speaker's call, ma'am.
Yeah.
Can you check?
Yes, sir. I think sir has to unmute by himself. I think I'll call him. I'll call sir.
In the words of M.F. Dilte, the Dalit literature is the voiceless found a voice here, the wordless found a word here. In the 60s, the word Dalit became an explosive catchword for social, cultural, and political revolutionary movement launched by untouchable caste, essentially the Magas, in such expression as Dalit literature. The British Indian Empire gave some basic reform scheme to the historically deprived society. Identity has been a recurring theme for the majority of the writers in India. The question identity is more often than not addressed from the point of social marginalization. Dalit writers and intellectuals are divided on these issues. Dalit writers and activists today stridently oppose the cultural stereotyping of Dalits. Dalit literature expresses rejection of the unequal order and demands equality, liberty, fraternity, and justice. And there is revolt in their writings to overcome the anguish and rejection. The experiences conveyed in Dalit literature constitute an engagement in self-search to achieve self-respect and rejection of the tradition and a religion that are opposed to such self-respect. Dalit literature aims to highlight the disabilities, difficulties, atrocities, and inhuman treatment meted out to Dalit in society. The main object to create social awakening among the downtrodden. Dalitness is essentially a means towards achieving a sense of cultural identity. The inferiority complex based on to be a Dalit is now disappearing. If you want understand the Dalit literature, just you have to refer the notable writers' works in Dalit literature. The notable writers in Dalit literature, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, Jyotirao Phule, Mahatma Phule, Arjun Dangle, Namad Dasal, Meena Kandasamy, Bama, Ajay Navariya, Leeladhar Mandloi, Manoranjan Raja Dale, P. Sivakami, Saran Kumar Limbale, Imayam, Gaddar, Dr. C. S. Chandrika, Daya Pawar, Urmila Pawar, Ravi Kumar, Baby Kamble, and Anida Bharti. And also, how the tribal literature is called as a subaltern literature. Tribal literature is the literature of a search for identity or exposing the past and present form of exploitation by the outsiders and threats to tribal identity and existence and resistance. Tribals are Adivasi or original dwellers living in the subcontinent from uncovered time and possibly driven into the forest by more aggressive settlers. Aryans being the earliest one to socially subjugate them. The term tribe is derived from Latin root ribus, meaning the three division into which the early Romans were grouped. Any one of three divisions of the people representing Latin, Sabine, and Etruscan settlements, or any of the later political division of the people. The word tribes refer to a cultural heritage and historical identity concept. Latin, Sabine, and Etruscan settlements, or any of the later political a cultural heritage and historical it is used for a tribe.
Latin, Sabine, political cultural heritage.
It is used for a tribe.
Mahendra Verma sir, kindly.
As a separate group of person having their own identity and cultural traits. The tribes are lives in isolated areas, and their social lifestyle is different from neighboring society. Tribal writings are different. Tribal writers have benefited from the rich oral literary tradition of the community. There is no central genre of tribal literature like autobiographical writings in the case of women's literature and Dalit literature. It draws energy from the tradition of tribal uprisings, the language and geography of those uprisings also assume significance. The tribal literature in Hindi is greatly influenced by rich literary tradition of indigenous languages. Yeah, part of this literature has been translated into other languages. The literature written different tribal language is translated into major languages like Hindi, Bangla, Malayalam, Telugu, Toda, and Tamil, the succeeding national form. Tribal literature supports the rights to protect their water resources, forests, land, and the right to self-determination. Tribal and non-tribal writers have portrayed tribal life and society through poetry, stories, novels, and plays. Tribal literature is marching ahead, imbued with the rebellious sentiments of the Birsa and Sido Kano and other revolutionary tribal leaders and their movements. The contemporary tribal writings and the discourses are in the early stages. It is heartening to find that useless debates like empathy versus sympathy are on its mind. If you want to understand more about tribal literature, just you can refer the writings of G.N. Devi, Verrier Elvin, Gopinath Mohanty, Narayan, L.P. Vidyadi, Kumar Suresh Singh, Dosh Mukheta, Alice Ekka.
Anand Kumar sir, stop presenting on the screen.
Sunil Jana.
Brahma ma'am, please kindly present it again.
Aindya Sakamat and Dara Sangar. So these writers are famous tribal writers in India. If you want to know more about the tribal literature, just you refer to these writers. it was African-American this literature also how the Dalit, how the tribals, their writings and literature origin from the oral variety, the black writings, the black literature also origin from that. African literature advancing wavefront in the United States of America during the 20th century as the voice of the protest against racial discrimination. African Americans have prevented from enjoying life because of African literature is the literature from Africa and includes oral literature. It primarily consists of memoirs by people who had escaped from slavery. The genre of slave narrative includes accounts of life under slavery and path of justice, freedom, and redemption. African American literature began with the slave narratives. It is nothing but a struggle for freedom, equality, and fraternity. Even the American whites aspired for liberty from the reigning region of British. They did not treat the slaves with that human love and dignity. The black appealed to the traditional Christian gospel of the universal brotherhood of humanity. African American literature challenged the dominant cultures, attempt to segregate the religious from the political, the spirit from the flesh, in so far as racial affairs were concerned. This new genre of writing in America began during the times of slavery, 1619 to 1865. Some slavery narratives have used as a potpourri of genres. Slave narratives were anti-slavery, direct to national and international audience. African American writing is another word called black writings. It is an important part of the English literature. It is also considered as a body of literature written by writers of African descent in United States. African American literature, starting with the narrative by slaves in pre-revolutionary period, focused on freedom and abolition of slavery. The period followed the Civil War until 1919 is dubbed the Reconstruction period. Its themes were influenced by segregation, lynching, migration, and women's subjugate movement. The earliest African American literature were focused on the indelible stain of slavery on American soil. The writers focused on themes of slavery, emphasizing cruelty, indignity, and ultimate human dehumanization of slaves. They were mostly written by slaves who had escaped into freedom. African American literature explores the issues of freedom and equality long denied to black in the United States. This literature presents the African American experience from African American point of view. In the early republic, African American literature represented a way for free blacks. The African American race was ghettoized, persecuted, and viciously outlawed from all avenues of decency, hope, progress, and livelihood. The basic myth of racism is that white skin brings with its culture its cultural superiority, that white are more intelligent and more virtuous than the black by the mere fact of being white. On psychological level, whiteness is automatically equated with beauty and culture, and blackness with the ugliness and slavery. When the African slaves were torn from his homeland and brought to the new world, he has quickly denied his native culture. If you want to know more about the African literature and also black identity, you can refer the writings of Toni Morrison, James Baldwin, Alice Walker, Sora Neale Hurston, Ralph Waldo Emerson, Langston Hughes, Richard Wright, Maya Angelou, W.B. Du Bois, Octavia Esler Butler, Malcolm X, Lorraine Hansberry, Amiri Baraka, Gloria Naylor, Alex Haley, Please Wheatley, Clad McKay, Chronicled Barbara, and the others' writings. The same issues we could see in the Aboriginal literature. So, Aboriginal literature is an inimical descendant of your oral tradition and the transmission of storytelling. It holds an important position in the lives of many Aboriginal people, and therefore, the elders of the Aboriginal communities find it important to pass on this knowledge to younger people and articulate the black past and contemporary Aboriginal identity. Aboriginal are considered as indigenous people. The word indigenous not only refers to the people, but to animals and plants. This term, though more widely accepted as an appropriate reference, is not preferred by Aboriginal Australians because of its inclusion of plants and animals in its meaning. Internationally, this is the more accepted term and is also preferred use by United Nations. Aboriginal people are familiar to most by having dark skin. This is not the case, but it does make for another negative association, the term Aboriginal. Racism is the greatest scourge Aboriginals have needed to fix with, and they are, as yet, fighting a willful type of prejudice that keeps them separate from appreciating the balance and value that different Australians underestimate and appreciate in that nation. Aboriginal people need to be acknowledged as a people with as much rights and obligation as different Australians. They would prefer not to be separate against them, or though of us unique in relation to mankind, since they are Aboriginals. However, need to experience their lives free from the scourge of any sort of prejudice, since they have much to offer to this inside and out. Their battle for social equity in the field of prejudice is progressing until the point that white Australians accept Aborigines as a vital part of Australian culture. Indigenous people are a significant and important portion of humanity. Their heritage, ways of life, stewardship of this planet, and cosmological insight are an invaluable treasure also for all. Most of the indigenous people, the natural world is a valued source of food, health, spirituality, and identity. Land is both a critical resource that sustains life and major cause of struggle and even death. Each indigenous culture is distinct and unique. While many people can express similar world views and a common indigenous identity, their cultures are nonetheless based on different histories, environment, and creative spirit. Aboriginal literature initially descended from the oral tradition and transmission of storytelling. It holds an important position in the lives of many Aboriginal people, and therefore, the elders of the Aboriginal communities find it important to pass on this knowledge to younger people, especially children, through this storytelling tradition, through this storytelling tradition, through these aboriginal writings. Indigenous people nowadays raise awareness regarding the preservation of their cultural heritage. There are numerous aboriginal stories throughout Australia, Canada, and New Zealand, where different stories are known to different communities and regions. The most known stories are the stories of the dreaming, which tell about a particular aboriginal community's ancestral being and history and making of its people. Today, Dalit, tribal, black, and aboriginal writings are traced from the oral narratives. So if you compare Dalit writings, tribal writings, black writings, and aboriginal writings, all these writings origin from the oral narratives, and also all the writings, the writers are trying to get cultural identity and history. These people are united as indigenous. Dalit people, tribal people, black people, and also aboriginal people, all of them united as a indigenous people. The liveliness and authenticity of their expressions are captured all across their writing frame. Shame, anger, sorrow, and indomitable hope are the trademark of these marginalized people and literature created by them. If you want to know more about the aboriginal writings, just you can refer the writings of Alexis Wright. Munro, Tara Jane Winch, Kevin Gilbert, Lee Miracle, Larissa Beth. Robin Austin Highway, Jackie Higgins, Janet Upstrand, Maria Campbell, Basil Head Johnson, Emily Pauline Johnson, and others writing. Our global level, all the writings is about the experience of the indigenous people. In India, we have the subaltern people, Dalit people, and tribal people. These people are claimed indigenous people in India. The black people are from the African countries, they are indigenous people. In Australia, Canada, New Zealand, these indigenous people also claimed, and these aboriginal people also called, they are indigenous. But the majority of the people is suffered by the hands of the minority. For example, just to take an example of the South Africa, the majority of the people are black. Majority of the people are blacks. But until hundreds of years, that the rulers are whites from before the Nelson Mandela. So we also take an example of the during the apartheid era, how the black people in South Africa were neglected or excluded. So if you take all these writings, all these subaltern people, these people are neglected or excluded the mainstream society. These people wants to get their own identity and also history. It is the main focus of the subaltern literature. Through the writings, they are getting their dream. They are achieving their dream. So subaltern literature is a literature to gain or to achieve the marginalized people and also equality. It is the nutshell of the speech.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
And now it's Q&A session, so you can ask your question to sir.
Okay, madam.
The participants will ask you on the topic, sir. Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah, now you can, the participants can start asking your questions.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, sir.
I'm Senthil from Kerala College, Madurai, sir.
Okay, sir.
Thank you for your wonderful speech on subaltern literature or subaltern studies. You have covered everything dealing with subaltern studies. Here, my question is, there is an essay called Why Commonwealth Literature Does Not Exist, written by Salman Rushdie. There may be a chance of writing an essay called Why Subaltern Literature Does Not Exist. I don't know. Somebody may write it. And any piece of writing, even if you take a poem or an essay or a short story or a novel, is to persuade the readers to act accordingly, or to inform the readers, or to entertain the readers, or a combination of any one of them. My question is, how do we mitigate or lessen or reduce this issue, sir? How do we mitigate or lessen or reduce this particular issue?
So, if you compare 3 decades before, what is the status of the subaltern people? The subaltern writings developed after the 1970s. After the 1970s, all the subaltern people or affected people write their experience through the writings. And they write their experience in the writing. The public or people or the authorities or administrator understand the issues. And nowadays, these issues reduced by the authorities. So then through the writings, they can list the...
Thank you, sir.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, sir. Tell me, sir.
Hyderabad. Sir, my question is, where can we place Amitav Ghosh? Amitav Ghosh in the context of displacement and bondage in relation with subaltern. The terms displacement and bondage of Amitav Ghosh literature. So can we relate displacement and bondage to Amitav Ghosh novels?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please, sir. You could just elaborate a few points.
Actually, the most of the migration writers, diaspora writers, their experience also like the subaltern experience. Even the most of the people misunderstood the subaltern is only for the experience of the white people, tribal people, black people, and Aboriginal people. So if you refer the Gayatri Chakravarti's subaltern speaker, that book, you can understand the women also called considered as a subaltern once in India. Now after the feminism, the women get the equality, and also the indigenous writers, Amitav Ghosh and other writers, diaspora writers. The diaspora writers write their displacement. They're displaced through their writings. The people came to understand their issues, the displacement issues nowadays settled. So not only for the Amitav Ghosh, all the diaspora writers, diaspora writings, reveals their displacement and also cultural identity.
Sir, good afternoon.
Hello. Sir, good afternoon. Sir, if you want to know more about this subaltern, just you see the book Subaltern Discourses. The author is myself, the MJ publication. You can say if you want more detail about subaltern literature, just refer to the book.
This is Ayyappan from Mar Gregorius College of Arts and Science. First of all, I would like to thank your wonderful speech. You listed out so many Dalit literature, Dalit writers, but you missed Pandita Rayothi Das, sir. Hello, sir.
I think sir has some network problem or something. Sir, are you on the line?
Yeah, I'm on the line.
Deva Sivamani, sir, are you on the line?
Hello, sir.
Tell me, sir.
This is Ayyappan, sir. This is Ayyappan from Mar Gregorius College.
Okay, sir.
You listed out so many writers, Dalit writers.
Okay, sir.
What about Pandit Ayothi Das? I think he is the pioneer of Dalit writings, right?
Pandit Ayothi Das is the pioneer in Tamil Nadu. And also, he is a pillar of Dalit writings in Tamil Nadu.
Yes, sir.
What is today the researcher used the writings that just I asked for my last word, etc.
Okay. He is not an extra person, sir. He is the pioneer because so many Dravidian movements comes from his speech.
Okay, sir. I understand.
Okay, thank you.
Any more questions?
Good afternoon, sir. Yeah, hello.
Good afternoon, sir.
Sir, I am Shakti from Coimbatore.
Yes, sir.
Sir, thank you so much for a very elaborative presentation on subaltern.
Thank you, sir.
And in one of your presentation, you were talking about the voice of the voiceless communities.
Yes, sir.
Yes, nowadays, in India especially, we can say that transgender peoples, the trans communities, can they or can we add them under, yes, transgenders or trans community people?
Yes, sir.
Can we just bring them under the subaltern or should we be dealing them under the gender studies?
So, transgender, if you do research, transgenders also under the category of the subaltern. They are also considered some marginalized in the society. Already I told you, those who are politically, socially, economically neglected group, these groups are called subaltern.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Transgenders also neglected the society socially, politically, and economically. So they are also come under the umbrella of
subaltern.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Any questions, sir? Any more questions, participants? Chandrasena, ma'am?
Madam, I have a question.
Yes, please, sir.
Sir, good evening, sir.
Good evening, sir.
Sir, I have one question. What's the similarities between diasporic, subaltern and cultural studies, sir?
So, the similarities is cultural identity.
Cultural
identity. Subaltern people also want to get the cultural identity. Diaspora people also want to get that cultural identity. The cultural identity is a similarity.
Okay, okay. Sir,
tell me.
If anybody in Tamil Nadu who completely focuses on those kind of areas, sir?
For writers, sir?
Yes, sir, of course, sir.
So, there is a lot of people. So, if you refer Pama writings, Shivakami writings, Neena Kandaswami writings, Umayam's writings, Ravikumar's writings.
So Ravikumar means, sir, Ravikumar means present day MP, sir?
MP.
Okay, sir.
My candidates done the PhD. Three candidates completed a PhD and four candidates have completed MP in Samaltan.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Sir, there was a question in the chat. Do you want to take it, sir? From Venkata Gona Reddy, sir. Sir? Devasigamani, sir? There is a question in the chat. You want to take the question, sir? There is a question in the chat. How do you define Shivashankara Pillai novel and Mulkaraj Ninsar novel? Which depicts the pathetic conditions of untouchables, pathetic lives of untouchables. So how, that was a question from Venkat Gona Reddy Maram from, sir, do you want to answer?
Hello?
Sir, can you hear me, sir?
Yes.
Actually, yes, sir.
Dalit literature or Dalit writing is not only the writings of the Dalit people, but you have to understand. The writings about the life and experience of the Dalit people. The life and experience of the Dalit people. Even the Mulkaraj Anand's Untouchable. The Mulkaraj Anand's Untouchable is also life and experience of the untouchable boy, Baka. So those who are dealt these kind of issues, the pathetic condition, inhuman treatment, all the writings come under the subaltern.
Okay, I think the question is answered. Ma'am, Chandrasekharaman.
Yes, ma'am. I would like to thank our eminent research person, Dr. T. Devasigamani, for his wonderful presentation and covering the topic subaltern literature in the global assistance. He has beautifully explained and elaborated on the topic, that each one of us could understand what you are saying. But in between, there were some technical snags which hindered the flow of the presentation. And certain participants did not even consider others' difficulties. But anyway, we are thankful to everybody for participating in this program and Dr. T. Devasigamani sir for his wonderful presentation. I would request now Indira, Deputy HOD, Karpagavadi ma'am to...
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, thank you very much.
Okay, ma'am. Shall I start, ma'am?
Yes.
Thankfulness is the beginning of gratitude. Gratitude is the completion of thankfulness. It is a privilege and a great joy for me to extend a vote of thanks to all the good souls who contributed to making this one-day EFTP Learner Anatomy in ESL classes. I would like to thank our founder chairman, Dr. A.C.S. Sanmugam, Honorable President, Engineer A.C.S. Arun Kumar, giving us a platform and opportunity to conduct this EFDP in the pandemic situation. It gives me immense pleasure to thank our Vice Chancellor, Dr. Geeta Lakshmi, beloved Provost, Dr. Gopalakrishnan, Registrar T.B. Palanivelu, Joint Registrar H.N.S. Dr. Malini Pandey for the great support. I wish to thank the two pillars of first year campus, Dr. D.B. Jagaraj, Joint Registrar, Dr. N.S. Subhashree, Dean E.N.S. for extending your constant support for our department. I wish to express my sincere gratitude and appreciation to my beloved Registrar Supervisor and guest speaker, Dr. T. Deva Sigamani, Associate Professor of English, Annamalai University, Chidambaram, who raised this occasion with his presence. Before concluding, let me express my special thanks to our Dean, Dr. Mary Thomas, HOD, Dr. Chandrasena Rajeshwaran, and also the faculty members of our department for their effort. I wish to thank all the participants present today. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Participants, before we wind up certain instructions, your feedback form will be reaching you through your mail and also through the WhatsApp group. You can fill in the feedback form and get your certificates, so you need not worry about it. And the two PPTs of the sessions, or two PPTs of two sessions, will be shared in the WhatsApp group as well as in our MGR DG Learn. So you can
YouTube.
In all YouTube. So we'll tell you the right form. And you can go and see the session also, the recorded session. And PPTs will be shared. Many of you have asked us for that. So we will definitely share the PPT in the WhatsApp group also. And PME, you do need not worry. Thank you so much.
So sir, you can wind up. Dr. Deva Sigamani, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much, sir.
Wonderful session,
sir. Professor, sir.
Thank you for having wonderful.
Sir. Hello. Sir, can I get your number, sir?
Thank you.
Deva Sigamani, sir. Sir.
9435.
Sir, one minute, sir.
Sir. Thank you.
9445. 76933, sir.
76933. Okay. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.
Participants, you can wind up.
We'll wind up.
Yes, ma'am. We'll wait till the participants leave the forum.
Yes.
Thank you, ma'am.
All your queries will be, some of you have asked for the mail IDs. We will definitely forward you. Participants, you can leave.
Yeah.